prayed for his friends who misunderstood him, and it changed everything. You and I can do the same. Job chapter 42, verse 7 and 10. And so it was after the Lord had spoken these words to Job that the Lord said to Eliphaz the Temanite, "My wrath is aroused against you and your two friends, for you have not spoken of me what is right, as my servant Job has." Verse 10. And the Lord restored Job's losses when he prayed for his friends. Indeed, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. Many of us are familiar with the story of Job in the Bible. How all of a sudden calamity after calamity struck his life. He lost a lot of his possessions. He lost many of his family members until his own health was affected. And we see his four friends come, to him, and even his own wife, and there could have been others as well, who did not understand what was going on in his life. We see the record. In fact, the book of Job is a record of what his friends tell him. And during the course of that interaction, we find Job making statements like this. He says, "I am one mocked by his friends." He says, "My friends scorn me, my relatives have failed, and my close friends have forgotten. All my close friends abhor me, and those whom I love have turned against me." And we see these statements that Job makes throughout the course of that book. You know, these friends misunderstood him, and it is possible in life that our close friends, or even our family, may misunderstand what is happening in our lives. They may accuse us, they may condemn us, they may say that we are in the wrong, they may speak lies against us, they may stop connecting with us, so on. So anything could happen to those human friendships that we have. And in Job's case, he felt that. He said, "Even my close friends have forsaken me, my own relatives have forsaken me." But as we come to the end of the book of Job, God instructs Job, or he leads Job, to do something very important. We see here in verse 10 that Job prayed for his friends. You know, God never said, "Job, what your friends have done is wrong, and so just, you know, forget them and don't even care for them." No. God says, "Job, what your friends have done is wrong, but here's what you need to do." Job prayed for his friends. And the Bible says that when Job prayed for his friends, the very friends who falsely accused him, who said all kinds of wrong things against him, whom Job felt they had forsaken him, when he prayed for them, the Bible says God did something in Job's life. It says God restored everything in Job's life, gave him twice as much as he had. Now, we don't understand necessarily all the spiritual dynamic that took place, but I think it's sufficient to say here that something powerful took place when Job prayed for the very friends who accused him falsely, who said all kinds of harsh things against him. Something powerful happened, so powerful it changed his life. When friends misunderstand you, do what Job did. Pray for them, release blessing over them, speak forgiveness over them. Powerful things can happen when we do that. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for friendships. We thank you for people around us. And yet we understand that sometimes our friends can fail us. Our relatives can fail us. And earthly relationships, Lord, can weaken and maybe even turn against us. But Father, help us to learn to forgive, to learn to pray, to learn to release blessing on friends and people who may do this to us. We thank you for the powerful things that result when we pray for those who have wronged us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.